Alright, so Zasujet Tavarichi, and welcome to my. It's third part now. Turning back the clock. So, yeah, welcome to my third part of Let's Play Empire Total War. And in this part, I've managed to conjure up enough forces to make a desperate siege and take out the Georgians. This is a pretty risky move. I am slightly outmanned and outgunned here. But if I'm able to win this battle, then it will pay off in spades, because I'll have conquered Georgia, and that means I'll have two schools. And having two schools this early in the game is a huge advantage, and it will allow me to get get a lot more technology faster than my counterparts. So let's cross our fingers and hope for the best, eh? Alright, so here we go. We're starting our battle against the Georgians, and I've actually managed to fool them into attacking me. I'm going to pull my general back a little bit, and the cat has decided that it's going to help me in this battle, and the way is it decided that it's going to stand in front of the screen and obscure my view. So I'm going to try and make her go away, but she's back. She's probably going to be a nuisance throughout this map, but hold on a sec. Get out of here. I don't need your help. Go! Okay, and we're back. Sorry about that. But, I basically got my line infantry all set up to defend my general. And I got two regiments hiding in the forests, and I'm gonna try and have them sneak around the back and try and flank these Georgian fellows. In fact, I'm gonna move these guys back just a little bit more. For my general too. Alright, so skip ahead a bit until something exciting happens. Alright, so they have some cavalry and they're just like walking right on into my musket range. I'm not really doing anything about it. So I don't know. And they got some guys coming in here. Gonna get these guys into a square. Hopefully they'll be able to deal with those guys pretty effectively. Oops, got some more cavalry coming on in. Get in the square, fellows. And you'll be fine. So, yep. I thought they were fleeing, but they'll flee pretty soon. They're in pretty rough shape. So, they're not going to be sticking around too much longer, I hope. But their main force is rapidly bearing on me, and I gotta be prepared. Actually, my plan is a little bit different, considering that they have mostly armed citizens, and none of them have bayonets. I have far superior melee abilities, but they have more guns, so I'm actually going to charge their lines in hopes of creating a mass rout by making all the citizens rout and use that momentum to get the rest of the enemies to rout. It's really risky, but I hope to God it's going to work. And the freaking cat is back. But so yeah, they're coming in. There go those guys. I don't think I'm gonna even need guns. I'm gonna mount up the bayonets right now and get ready to charge. My general isn't even under attack. Oh, he is too. He's under attack by 5 horses. Spooky stuff. But, yeah, they're all ready with their bayonets, and I'm charging. Hold on a second again. Alright, so all our combatants have, all my troops have committed to a horrible melee battle in the center. I'm hoping that my superiority in numbers and everything will be enough to force them to retreat. But I've actually got a little ace in the hole, I suppose. I'm gonna have these guys emerge from behind. I'm gonna have these guys try and take out their general. But I'm gonna have the rest of my melee troops coming from behind and hopefully take them out. Looks like one regiment is routing as we speak. I'm going to speed this up a little bit. Woohoo! A little bit of lag, but we'll be fine. So yeah, I gotta get these guys in behind and hope that I can cause a rout as fast as possible. I'm pretty sure if I can get these guys to attack these militia from behind, they will rout. Let me get you to keep on moving there so you can get them. Alright, they're in ready. And they're coming in from behind. And it doesn't look like I'm gonna be forcing a rout from them. Oh, maybe on this end I'm getting a few units to get up and go. I'm keeping their I was hoping to shoot at them, but it doesn't look like it's gonna work as well as I hoped. Had my general come in, these guys are also wavering. These guys are gone. And it looks like I might actually pull through as more and more Georgian flags are becoming white and are fleeing. Looks like their entire army just broke into a mass rout, and I could pull through. My daring plan just might work. I keep my general safe, because if I lose him, it might all be over for me. But looks like pretty much all of their units are running from this battlefield. I'm gonna start chasing down some of them, make sure they can't come back. And all that's left is this, these cavalry regiments. I'm gonna try and put my guys in the squares. Hopefully. Doesn't look like it's gonna happen. But my general's in the back. He's dealing with some he's making sure to make sure that they're not coming back. And as long as I can get these guys to rout, I'll be okay. But these armed citizens are taking shots at my generals, and I think I'm gonna have to pull them out. I don't think he'll survive that. I'm gonna attack them from behind in hopes that I can get him to rout. Okay, I got the armed citizens to rout. But if I can get these guys out of here. Yes! Got their general down. And I think I can call it game pretty quickly here. Thank you, Cat. Yes, they're broken. They're broken. And all that's left are a few citizens hanging out. And I'm gotta be honest, I cannot believe that freaking worked. That was like a 1 in a million shot, and I can't believe that it pulled through in the end. Like, holy crap. There we have it. That's victory. Ending the battle. Wasn't pretty, but we had a kill to death ratio of almost 2-1. And I'm only hoping that with this I don't leave using myself open to a Persian assault. But that's gonna be it for this Let's Play. Thank you guys for watching. This is JosefVStalin, signing off for now.